Hey guys, how's it going? Preparing here. In this video, I'm going to show you guys how revenge actually works on a barbarian. It's the most important skill, in my opinion, because it's your primary source of healing, and if you play a barbarian like I do, it's pretty much your primary source of damage as well. So, let's get started. First, the first thing to compare is how does revenge work? Well, when you get hit, it triggers the proc, and then when you use the ability, it gives you a cooldown. Now this cooldown, as you can see here, is not affected by your weapon speed. If you use a slow weapon or a fast weapon, or if you have any kind of haste modifiers from shrines or even like Wrath of the Berserker, it doesn't make any difference. The cooldown is approximately 1 second, and you really can't spam it faster than this cooldown, even if you're getting the proc come up from getting hit. Now, the next thing to consider is, when does it proc? Is it just melee attacks? Well, it's a little bit more complicated than that. I think if you play your barb enough, you'll be able to see when it procs. There are certain situations that I have seen that it procs that are a little bit surprising. For instance, on the mobs you can see there with the lightning, each tick of the lightning does actually proc revenge. I know that Plague sometimes procs it as well. I know that Electrified procs it a lot. So sometimes these things work, but in contrast, there's certain attacks that certain mobs do that have some kind of reduced proc rate. So you have to be careful, and it's best to closely examine when you're getting a lot of procs to be able to determine when they're coming in. Also, when it comes to stacking defense, you have to keep in mind that if you block an attack, a revenge has a chance to proc. But if you dodge an attack, a revenge cannot proc off of your dodge. Now that we have all the base mechanics out of the way, how do you really use revenge? See, revenge is a very interesting ability. See, when you use a cleave, for instance, it just cleaves the target, no problem. But if you use a cleave and then you use a revenge, you see that there's a hasted effect. If you do cleave cleave and then you do cleave revenge, you see that the cleave revenge ended a lot sooner than two cleaves. However, if you do revenge cleave, you'll actually notice that the time is about the same as two cleaves. The reason this works is revenge triggers a global, but it doesn't require one to use the ability. So if you use revenge first, you'll be locked out of using an attack for a full swing timer. But if you use a regular attack and then immediately follow it up with a revenge, you'll be able to do a lot more damage that way. The contrast is that if you're stalling your revenge, you are missing out on potential procs. In terms of damage, that's not a big deal. But in terms of defense, that can be a big deal. So this sets up the situation where you can use revenge in two different ways. You can use revenge offensively, where you deliberately follow it up after your regular attack, or you can use it defensively, where you just spam it and you cancel pretty much all of your regular attacks in doing so. Your damage is lower, but because you're using the cooldown right away, you have a higher opportunity for more procs. And more procs means more healing. So if you're facing a mob that's really, really dangerous, that's hurting you pretty bad, then don't worry about the damage. Just keep spamming that revenge key. There's also another thing with revenge. Revenge, in some situations, has a very good cancel animation property. So you can run and use revenge faster than you can run and use like a sidestep cleave, for instance. So that's also useful, because you can use revenge this way in running around mob packs, making sure you're not surrounded, at the same time healing yourself for a good amount. That's all I have to say about revenge. Try to play with it a lot. I think it's the most critical ability for any barbarian, and getting the practice in is going to give you the experience of when and how you're going to use it to the fine details of the ability. I'll see you guys next time.